what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNut and welcome back to our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough. Look at this squad, we have 6 troops in the bag, in the team, and now we're gonna use them to go on Operation Demon Saga, where we neutralize a advent personnel's person. So yeah, let's launch that mission. So 2 specialists and 2 rangers along with a grenadier and a sharpshooter. It's not a conventional squad makeup, I'll be honest. But we're gonna see how that works out. So there we go, 11 hours left on the timer, so let's begin that mission.
For some time now, the Resistance has been tracking a VIP known for working with the aliens. And they finally narrowed the target to a quadrant in this area. They've asked us to move in and deal with this person once and for all. As always, we'll need to eliminate any hostile forces protecting the package to secure the area. Capture the target if possible. Use force if necessary.
So this is something we haven't done yet. So capture or kill an enemy VIP. We can stun the VIP and take him with us. And if we do that, we get the intel that was marked on the mission. If we don't and we just kill him, the mission will still succeed, but we don't get the extra intel, because of course we don't have a VIP we can question. But back in Novgorod, Operation Demon Saga, the screen is freezing for some reason. Hopefully that moves forward. Yeah, okay, it does. Whew. Kinda had a mini heart attack there, so launch mission. And there we go, the epic rappelling down shot from the vehicle. Firebrand, is it? I think it's Firebrand.
Menace 1-5, target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
I think this is also one of those missions we have a timer on with the number of turns. Yeah, 12 turns, as usual with these kinds of missions. So we're still concealed, which is good. And let's use a Jazz Gypsy over here to move further. For some reason, we're starting on the roof. Which might not be that bad, but I'm just gonna check out what else is around there. Do we see any enemies yet? We don't. So let's use Jazz to move a bit further. Let's move everybody up slowly.
Verstanden. Bewege mich zum Ziel.
This is starting to be easy. Okay, so there's something over there. Can't really see it, but judging from the... Oh wait, I can. That's a Viper. There's one Viper over there that we need to, right next to the VIP, of course. So just, yeah, we're just gonna boost everybody up further as far as we can. Ulrich over there. Oh, I think he saw something. Okay, so a Shield Bearer and a Viper. That's good because there's only 2 of them. Who else do we have? We still have Christoph that we need to boost up further, so let's put him over there.
I'm all over it.
And then let's put Cedric in the corner here, so he has the highest position available to him right now. And everybody else downstairs. But it's still a higher position, so we still should get aim bonuses if we start shooting. Those guys are gone, so that's actually good. That gives us a bit more time to move into position. Freya can actually move all the way over there. So let's put you over there. And that gives you sight of the Viper again. Yeah, so they're moving around the statue. I do hear another turret as well, so we do need to be careful a bit. We need to over here in full cover. Cedric, you can stay over here. Well, now that we're here, we're just quickly going to check out the tower here, what we can get from hacking it. What bonuses we can get, because if there's a hacking boost, that might be really cool. So no. So squad recovers all action points already spent this turn. And a failure would give us a map alert. But that 30% might actually be cool. Distraction. Squad recovers all action points already spent this turn. Or with deception, you gain control of a random enemy for 2 turns. That might actually be very interesting as well. So hacking this tower is something that we're going to have to keep in mind. Because the percentages are going to be higher, because Benito's hacking ability is boosted because of the skull jack. So let's move you down. Let's move Jazz Gypsy down as well. Ordre bien reçu. Over there, Christophe. Let's put you behind the car. Do we need to start thinking about Overwatch, Schultz? There seems to be someone over there as well, or is that... No, it's a tower, it's a tower. Okay, never mind. So that's not anything we need to be worried about. So let's move everybody further even more. He's gonna see another group. That's probably the Viper, the group inside. Oh no, the turret, wow. That thing just got 4 armor on top of everything. So yeah, just let's put everybody as close as we can. Because we're gonna need it. There we go. And then Jazz, move you up a bit further as well. Not gonna spread you out too much. So let's get you right next to Benito over here. And then you on Overwatch. And then Christophe also a bit further, as far as we can. Ooh, this is tense. So we have 9 enemies, 9 turns left. I think they're gonna spot us, right? Because they jumped up for some reason. Okay, they don't. But I think it's high time we start shooting at something. What are the chances for us to hack that turret? Haywire protocol, hack the turret. Well, let's check it out either way. Let's see here. What are the percentages for taking that thing out? So 88 is a shutdown, so temporarily disable the unit. So that might actually be handy. If we could. 44 to take control. Could try that, but I'm not going to do that just yet. So let's just start firing at the troopers over there on the left. Well, the shield bear and the... Can I actually get... Ooh, I could get straight onto the shield bear's face. If I want to. But that would leave me vulnerable towards the Viper. And I could get a shot from over here on the shield bear as well. Do we have a flank shot of sorts? Don't want to use Christophe for this, but... I could use Ulrich to remove some of the armor of the turret. But then I... Because the turret is not going to take cover, of course. So I should use my first shot on the... The shield bear and the Viper. So here we go. 99% shot in the face. Oh yeah, 6 damage. So he's almost dead already. Gonna have to see what they do. Okay, that was a spooky noise. Yeah, he or she is mad. I'm gonna suppose she. And then the turret is gonna start... being on high alert as well, but let's see what we can do. So they took a very smart flanking position, but of course we're just as smart. So Hugh, would you like to get in the face of the shield bear and blast him with every 87%? Are you fucking kidding me? But there he goes, 6 damage on the critical. That's actually pretty low for a critical, because he does a minimum of 5 damage as well. So let's see, what else can we do? We need to take care of that Viper over there, so... Huh. What can your sword attack do? So 3 to 5 damage, that's not really good. But we could get you into a pretty nice position and try a shotgun from over there. His stuff is still concealed, so that is something to keep in mind as well. But first, let's take care of the turret. 72% chance. That's actually not that great. Could use a frag grenade, but that's gonna do more harm than good. So let's just use the mag cannon for the very first time. And start it off with a freaking miss. Okay. Oh, did we trigger anything? Because I saw a lot of bars over there. Don't we get... No, we don't. Ooh, this is... This is worse than I anticipated. I think it's high time. You know what? Hacking is only 1 turn, right? So if I can get a haywire protocol in and just disable it, could take control, but that went really, really badly last time. So let's just shut it down. Oh, for fuck's sake, no way. 88% and I lost that. Increase targets' aim and defenses. Okay, that's not... Well, that's really bad, actually. That's really, really bad. I think we still have... Oh, shit. Yeah, I fucked up. I thought that wouldn't be two turns, that hacking. Okay, I really fucked up this time. Let's see. We're gonna get Jazz up closer and see what we can do with him. So the turret is boosted because we only have 43% chance to hit it now, but I can hit the Viper for 62% chance. Please kill it. Oh, thank you. That was a nice introduction, Jazz. That was really, really nicely done. So now we're gonna have a problem. We have... God damn it. We have only one action left, and that turret has higher ground, and I wonder why that from above didn't trigger. That is really, really weird. Sometimes that triggers, sometimes that doesn't. Could get you closer, but I think I'm gonna trigger... I'm not gonna trigger them because he's in concealment, but... How far can I throw a grenade? If I can get a grenade... No, never mind. That was a pipe dream. No. Okay, so I'm gonna have to just put you on overwatch then. Ooh, this is gonna hurt. So he's gonna fire twice. That was 6 damage. If he fires that again, if he does that again, Ulrich is dead. Okay.
Be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
I have no... Wow. That was kind of lucky. I thought the turrets got to fire twice, but apparently they don't. So let's put Ulrich over there in a better defensible position, and then let's just fire a freaking grenade on top of that roof. I'm just gonna let him have his revenge. Nope. Can I do? Yeah, I can do. I saw it. Yeah, thank you very much. Let's just blast a hole in that, and just that's gonna drop down the... Wait a second. Am I gonna kill the civilian? The VIP? You know what? I don't give a fuck. I really don't give a fuck, but I think he was further back in the building, so don't need to be afraid of that. That's gonna kill the turret outright and make a giant hole in the building. Goodbye, turret. Thank you very much.
I gotcha.
So there's the VIP. I don't see a target model. Did you forget confirmed. To place someone over there?
Remember, we're here to capture the VIP if possible. Knock him out and bring him in.
To capture the VIP, move a soldier to close range and use the subdue ability, then carry the unconscious VIP to the evac zone. So with that done, might actually get a bit closer. We're not triggering anything yet, and I think I'm gonna have to move Cedric, just boost him all the way up here, because he's not gonna get much from that positioning anymore. We still have 8 turns, which is plenty. Should also need to move towards... I think I'm gonna have to do that with Jazz. Just gonna put Jazz over here to get the loot. There we go, get that in the bag. Another Illyrium core, always handy. That's weird, because I think we have Vulture, so that should always give us 2 items, but apparently that didn't trigger right there. This game is full of bugs. Hugh, you know what to do, eh? Because you're on healing duty at the moment. Gremlin heal on Vryar, thank you very much. I think that only will heal 4 damage, but it's something at least. There we go. A nice 4 HP heal. And now... Do I want to rush this already? I don't think I want to do that just yet. So Vryar is over there, so I should be safe to put Jazz over here. Unless there's a pod on the left and I'm just fucked. Okay, never mind. Fubberknuckled. His stuff is still in concealment, so we might as well move him further.
Okay.
Do you see anything else? Because there should be something else there as well. Seems to be something in the back there. Nothing. Okay. That is interesting. Oh, gold. Okay, so that was that Viper in the back. Oh, never mind. 6 damage. Thank you, Benito. And he marked him as well because of his ability. So that Viper is as good as dead. Okay, so that's 1 Viper. Ooh, and those guys, 3 Vipers. And they're heading inside of the building. That might be bad. I think I have an idea. Could use lightning hands on that. Wow, even with the boost, that just doesn't do anything now, does it? Could fire the sniper rifle, but I don't want to do that just yet. Let's move everybody a bit closer, because Hugh is over here in the back and he doesn't have a shot. He still doesn't. Jazz actually has. But what can Jazz do? We could put him over here and take care of that single Viper immediately. Oh, there's the VIP. Okay, so 31% on the Viper. That's not good, but he has a grenade. Oh, it would have been nice if I could take out that that wall over there as well, but I can't right now. But we still have Ulrich's gas grenade as well, so I'm thinking I'm gonna put that inside. So yeah, bye-bye, Viper. Meet Jazz, our gypsy guy. Goodbye. Oh, wow, she got blasted inside the railing there. So that's that. Then we have... How far does the gas grenade reach? Can I get it into a favorable position that I don't kill the VIP with either? I don't think I can get both of them. Unless maybe, of course, I can still move him as well. If I put you over here, what happens then? Because Christophe is still in concealment, so I might actually move him up a bit closer first. Before we do anything else. Not on the corner, because we might trigger anything else. Just saw his path. That was the reason why I was freaking out. There's something here. Yeah, okay. So there's a trooper, and I think that's another... An officer and a shield bearer over there. So that is pretty heavy. But as long as we don't get Christophe out of concealment, that shouldn't be a problem. So let's put Ulrich over here. Giving him a better view of everything. Not triggering anything either. So yeah, now we can get both of them in the same grenade. I don't think that a gas grenade removes structures. It shouldn't, because that's not really logically. But the gas grenade should get all of them and poison them all. There we go. And poisoned. Oh, of course. I am such a dumbass. Yeah, I am a dumbass. Yeah, because Vipers are, of course, they're snakes, so they're immune to poison. Okay. Cedric, what are your shots? Yeah, take out that Viper. Here we go. Dodge, dodge, the freaking dodges. I hate the freaking dodges. He is still up, indeed. Benito has a grenade, so that shouldn't be too hard. But what else can we do? Christophe can't do anything. What is your shot on the... This is a dilemma. Do I keep one of the Vipers alive or not? Or do I do the opposite? I think I'm gonna try and hack the pole. Because if I do that, I might actually get all my turns back. Here we go, system override. 40% to get all our action points back. I'm just gonna try it. Ooh, yes, yes, yes. Okay, the Vipers are down. Whew. Distraction. Squad recovers all action points already spent this turn. That was amazing. That was a bit of a gamble, but that was a gamble that paid off. So now we can do everything as if we were just starting this turn. Where can you actually grapple to? Oh. That is actually pretty nice. Kind of forgot that he had that. So that doesn't take an action, making this incredibly handy in a lot of situations. So, 79% with lightning hands, we're gonna take that. Take out the Viper. He dodged that as well. Are you freaking... Okay. So let's take the sniper shot on the back Viper. And that misses. Cedric is not in his A game today. And he's out of ammo. Great. We do need to be careful, because we only have 7 turns left. And I turned that place into a poisonous hellhole for some reason. Yeah, Benito, get in there. I hope you don't spot any of the troopers inside. Shoo, that's just a civilian, right? The VIP, okay. What? Oh, I can't see the Viper. I can't see the other Viper. That is an issue. Who else can see the other Viper? I think if I put Jazz over here on the outside, he will get a shot at the Viper. There we go. What are your chances? 26 and 65. 65 is pretty good, so let's try that. Oh, that was another miss. Things are not going good, are they? So we missed and we got a few dodges in. We have a flank shot on the Viper with Ulrich. That's pretty much it. Holy shit. With all those actions, we're still gonna have not enough stuff to take out the Viper, are we? So that's the Viper in the back, even. Okay. Might as well try that. Through the wall, apparently. Okay. So Benito still has a shot on that same Viper as well. But Ulrich, try your shot on the Viper on the right. That at least that guy is dead. Thank you very much. No dodges on that one. And now we have Benito's shot. Because if we move further, we're going to trigger that last batch. And Ulrich got a promotion. That's really, really nice. I think, yeah, that's our last action we can do. So I accidentally pressed Overwatch. That is bad, although... What are your shot percentages? 36, no, we're gonna put you on Overwatch as well. We have the advantage that Benito now can do an Overwatch shot on actions as well. So as long as that Viper moves, he's gonna get shot at. So let's just put Christoph on... Oh, sorry. Sorry, didn't mean to do that. You just ran into the poison. No, 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 no. Oh, shoo. Okay, he missed. That is another of the abilities of the Viper. He can grab troopers out of cover. And now he's gonna poison me. Yeah, yeah. Of course he does. Of course that son of a bitch does. So yeah, poisoned. That's not that bad. I'm gonna get closer. I know there's guys over there, but I think maybe with the hole we made, they're gonna spot us. But yeah, that's just gonna have to get dealt with then. Okay, we don't. What are the shot chances? 23, 22. Okay, so we're gonna need to put Cedric closer anyway. So how far is the extraction zone? It's pretty far, so I'm gonna have to start killing everything right now. Let's put you over here, Cedric, and then I can't use the grappling again, right? No. Okay, so I'm gonna have to reload. Then we have Ulrich over here. He could try another shot at the Viper. I don't know why Benito's shot didn't trigger his Overwatch shot. Hugh is also a very important part right now, so we're gonna heal Benito's poison. And I think that should be done with a pretty simple heal, right? Heal injured allies, because yeah, revival protocol is not even on, so if I heal Benito, his poison should go away as well. There we go. Healed and poison removed, probably. Now, 32% is not great. So let's put you a bit closer. And through the window, you should get a shot at the Viper again. 36 is again really, really bad. But I could use Benito's grenade, although I want to keep that for something else. Let's see. Jazz could go over here as well, but I'm afraid I'm going to start triggering those guys. I'm going to have to move you up anyway, so let's put you over here in full... Oh, no, no, shit. Yeah. That was very, very small now, wasn't it? 1% chance. Yeah, okay. That was a dum-dum. That was a really dum-dum. Just put you in the poison right there. Yeah, Ulrich, just try and get that done. I'm gonna use a grenade to blast open the wall over here, giving us a clear shot at the Viper and just killing him in the shot from Ulrich. There we go, wall removed. And now we have a clear shot with Ulrich, yeah, thank you very much. 76% chat. So, okay, I need to get my bearings a bit. So Ulrich's shot was apparently so powerful that he crashed the game. So I don't really know. So yeah, so Benito got damage from the healing, so from the poison. So we're at that point in the game, apparently. Do need to get my bearings a bit. Yeah, I needed to reload a previous save file just so we could do this now, shouldn't we? There we go. Blowing open the wall and clearing out the Viper, and then let Friar do the shooting as we were planning to. Ooh, straight in her face. She got a lot of holes in that face.
So wird's gemacht.
And then we're gonna boost Cedric up closer. Maybe even put him here. Oh no, that's gonna put him through the poison. Let's just put him here and reload.
Seems doable.
Use the heal on Benito and reload Cedric, and then of course we still have Christoph, but we're just gonna put him on Overwatch. There we go. So with that done, we have those three guys. Okay, welcoming us. Yes, I see them too. We see advent troops. And he just went into the poison, didn't he? So yeah, we have another Skulljack opportunity right now. We could do that, but we do need to be very, very careful right now, because this is the officer. So we could Skulljack him. I think we could probably even Skulljack him through the wall for some reason. Let's try that, shall we? So right here through the thingy. We do need to be careful. Just want to take out everything else before we even attempt. Oh. Hi? Ooh, this is going to be risky. I'm going to use the grappling hook again. And I'm not going to do it right there. I'm going to do it right there. Because the shield bearer put himself in a really, really bad position for some reason. So let's grapple you over there. Giving you a nice Overwatch shot at that shield bear. Wait. Oh no, that's Jazz because of his white outfit. I thought that was okay, never mind. Fire sniper rifle. That should give us the death from above. If of course he would be successful, but he's not. Okay. We're out of grenades, pretty much. So I think it's high time we use Christoph in this. We could try and get a sword slash in. I don't know where the third guy is. He's up here, apparently. I could get him, actually. What are the chances with the sword? Not the shield bearer, not the officer, but the... Yeah. The trooper. 96% chance. That should actually do it, right? I don't think... Do you get poisoned? It doesn't look like you could get poisoned, so... Oh, but it's only 3 to 5. Why does that change all of a sudden? I could take him out with running gun, though. So I could go over here, and that's actually probably better to do. Ooh, this is gonna have to be tight, tight, tight. The shield bear is still in half cover for some reason. I think it's kind of weird that he didn't get poisoned there as well. Should have done that first before I let Cedric shoot at him, but there we go. One armor shredded. And now we only need to do 6 damage on an open target. Why is Ulrich's aim so bad? I can't pull him closer because the poison is still here. Because the poison spit. But 66 is really, really bad. Yeah, we're going to use him to try a skulljack of the officer. And then we're going to have to see what we do otherwise. So, first thing we need to really do is kill that shield bearer. We still have Jazz as well. Could we move him? No, he's running through fire and everything, so that would be... God damn it, he's gonna have a real problem there. But yeah, 4 turns should be enough to get everybody out. Shield bearer, shotgun to the face. That was a miss. That was an 81% miss!
La cible a rien.
For fuck's sake! 66% then. Please. Yeah, okay, he's down. Okay. If the skulljack works, we should be able to get the officer. But that's really, 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 really risky. But yeah, let's do it. Oh, this is such a stupid idea. Oh yeah, we got him. We got him. Benito is in the wall right now, but let's...
Access to the Advent Psionic Network.
Ooh.
I have dedicated our systems to processing the new data, but we will need to work fast. It is only a matter of time before they detect our intrusion.
So a small cache of intel in the bag as well. About that large cache, but... But now, we're gonna have a bit of a problem. So the officer is down. But there we have a bit of a problem. And Jazz is back, for fuck's sake.
Commander, that appears to be the codex responsible for safeguarding the alien data stores. We'll have to neutralize it if we intend to recover the data.
Understood. Weapons hot. We've got our target.
Okay, so that triggers the codex. That thing over there. A lot of help, and that thing can teleport all over the place. So... What we're gonna do is play the safe game first. So we're gonna use run and gun, move up towards the trooper over here, and just blast him in the face. We should get a nice position up there, and that should instantly kill that trooper over there. If it doesn't, we're completely screwed. Spotted enemy, that's right, yes indeed. Revealed, but that's not... Can I get my shot in, please? Yeah, okay. 100% in the face. 90% chance on a critical, so that was the ammo at work. And now we need to do just the same thing for that codex. But is he gonna kill someone? Because Jazz is in a really, really bad position. Who is he firing at? Okay, so that's not that bad. So that's a psionic storm. That disables our weapons. But I didn't want to shoot at that thing too much either way, so I'm gonna have to really focus here. So that's just gonna start pulling everybody back, because we need to head towards that evac point as well. So disabled just means that it's disabled our weapons for one turn, but that didn't disable Jazz's weapon, I think. Oh, it did. Never mind. Just gonna pull Jazz back as well, because he's in a really bad position over there. The only guy that I do want to keep in mind is... Oh, he doesn't even see the... Oh god, this is going to be hard. Let's pull everybody back. The closer we could get towards the end, the better. Because I don't really need to kill the Codex. I do for the main quest, of course. But I don't really need to for anything else. If we stay in that area, that's going to explode as well. So that's not really nice either. Let's put everybody back. Benito, I could even pull you further. So let's just do that.
Posizione confermata.
Cedric, he's in a really, really bad position, but just gonna have to deal with it. Let's put you on the roof or not. I'm just gonna have to put you as close as I can without putting you in any danger. Let's put you over there. Jazz can't fire at the codex either, so let's put him over here in full cover. Kistoff might actually try, but I'm not gonna do that just yet. So let's put him further away as well, as far as we can. Let's put him over here.
Affirmative.
Oh, but we still... Oh, shit. That would have been perfect to subdue the VIP as well. But we're gonna have to put somebody else on that duty. Cedric still needs to move towards that, so... He might bring him along the way. So he teleports up there, which is good, I think.
Existing simultaneously across multiple
firing at Cedric in the face. Ooh, this is gonna have to be a giant balancing act. 3 turns left, and we still need to subdue that thing as well.
Menace 1-5, hostile interceptors are on high speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Oh shit, this is gonna hurt. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to kill him. I'm gonna have to kill him. Because I'm not gonna get him and get all our troops out, so... Let's put Jazz over here. And reload him. So that's one reloaded that needed to reload. Let's put... Kristoff a bit further and then put him on Overwatch. Because if we can get him to get a shot off on the... It's right over here, right? So if we can get him... Over here.
No problem, boss.
There we go. I think that was the last one. There we go. What's he going to do? He's going to teleport again to a really, really bad position. Yes, indeed. They're going to freak out, all of them. Overwatch. Okay, that's not bad. We might actually have a chance at this. Yes, yes, over there, over there. So. Cedric. Lightning hands the civilian. I'm really sorry about this, but I'm gonna have to kill you. Goodbye. That doesn't take an action.
Did you see that one?
Which allows him to move back.
Status confirmed. Target eliminated.
Cedric, can you give me Cedric? Yeah, there we go. What I'm going to do is... The Codex has a unique ability that it splits into the moment he gets shot. So to block that...
Whatever you say.
Oh shit, oh yeah, Overwatch, oh shit.
Over here.
He missed, oh god, otherwise Cedric would have been dead. That was really stupid. Yeah, but I didn't really have another chance. Where can I grapple to, actually? I can grapple up, but I can't grapple towards the end there. Shit, I don't think my plan is going to work. Because we'll only have one more turn, so I can't get him there immediately. So, yeah, I'm going to have to put him... I'm going to have to even put him in the open, I think, to get everybody out. Ooh. If I put you... Smongo over here.
I see. Je bouge.
He's in cover. Now I can use his... Wait, can I get... Oh, shit. Can't even get there. I'm gonna have to risk everything here. Because I need to get inside of the evacuation zone. Inside of that one turn. And otherwise I'm gonna just heal over and die. So let's put Benito in the evac zone. Maybe just outside of the evac zone.
Molto bene.
Vrijer. Gonna put you there as well.
Verstanden.
Cedric. I think I'm gonna just plainly lose him. Let's boost Jazz up as well. Cedric. I've done all that just to kill the Codex, and I'm not going to be able to kill the Codex. Unless maybe I get a flank shot from over here somewhere. But I don't really want to risk anything. So let's try that. Let's do a flank shot over here. And let's try this out. So 82% critical chance. That might kill him, might not. Otherwise, we're gonna have... Yeah, he even missed. He even missed. No biggie.
Adjusting sights.
So I don't think he splits on... Yeah, okay. There we go. So let's put him over here. He might die. Is he gonna teleport first? Yeah, he's gonna teleport. Ooh, that's an even better position. That's actually really good. That's actually really good, because he can't do anything else after that. So I'm just gonna extract everybody now. Oh god, hacking that officer was probably the worst decision ever. He doesn't get another action. Okay, yeah. We need to bug out of here.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position. Menace 1-5, you're out of time. Get to the evac point, now!
So now I need to be really, really careful. Don't push any buttons too fast. So,
kein Problem.
Ulrich in the evac zone. Benito inside of the evac zone. Cedric, not dashing. Just get you. Just gonna take everybody else first. So let's get you inside of the evac zone. Christoph inside of the evac zone.
I'm going.
Cedric, whew, inside of the evac zone.
I'm going.
And then Humongous inside of the evac zone as well. And then slowly evac everybody out of there. So that and evac.
Evacuation
evac. Oh, he wasn't reacting there for a second. Evac. Evac. No, you're not gonna fire at anything. How sad it even is, I'm not gonna fire on everything. Evac. Ooh, that was freaking close. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Excellent though, apparently. So a lot of wounded soldiers, which is not good, because I wanted to try the alien facility. And we do a 50% successful shot percentage. That was one of our worst missions ever. Because even Cedric had a really, really bad day there. Okay then. That's Operation Demon Saga. So there we go, landed back at the Avenger. Did we actually get any promotions? Because we did get 10 kills. One promotion. Ulrich got a promotion. Let's see. Heavy ordnance or holo targeting. Heavy ordnance. The grenade in your grenade only slot gains in bonus use. Or holo targeting. Any directed cannon shot will mark the target the same as Benito can do. We're going to go, of course, for heavy ordnance. Because an extra grenade is always really handy. Heavy ordnance. There we go. And then let's see what we got from... Jazz got a promotion as well. Never mind, I'm sorry. I'm going to make him our Blade Master. Hopefully that works out. We're going to make him the Blade Master. Extra damage with the sword. And then we got an Illyrium Court, 20 intel, and the VIP was killed, so we didn't get him.
Hello, Commander.
And then we get the supplies and not the intel, of course, because we can't get any intel from a corpse. It's said. Let's see if we can get through the bridge. Might actually quickly wait a second. Supply drop is still available. I know, not now. Let's go back for a second. I'm gonna quickly check out the engineers. I'm gonna take one engineer from the excavation time and put the next engineer in the advanced warfare center just to boost the healing rate. There we go, 100% extra, so that should double that up, because everybody is in there. Look at that, there's three guys in there. Cedric, Ulrich, and Benito are in the med bay. So if we go to the bridge, I want to get that scientist and then the supply drop before the
Avenger,
end of the timer. So back to the scientist. It's all pretty close together, so that should actually work. So, boost that up for a scientist. There we go. Among the last of the holdouts in this area, a small group of resistance fighters known as the Fire Axis made contact while we were scanning the region. One of our soldiers claims to have known several members of the elusive group and was able to recruit one of their scientists to join Dr. Tigan's lab. Okay, so research time decreased. And we got another landmark. We're going to have to ignore that for now. Are we going to go for our supply drop first? We should.
Avenger,
just going to quickly do that. So that's 3 days. We should still have 7 days left after that. but then it's high time we get that.
I have made a number.
Okay, that's really good. So assign new research. So we get the advanced grenade launcher, which is really good, and plasma grenades.
I doubt they thought anyone would resist when faced with the alternative of staring down a muton.
We need intel, so I'm going to go for the 4 days of that data path decryption. So there we go. Let's go back to the bridge and get ourselves some supplies. Here we go. Supplies 1, supplies 2, supplies 3, and I see a lot of recovering over there. So let's ignore that and not go to the resistance quickly. So let's get back and swap out that engineer again, because I think everybody is out. Oh no, Cedric is still healing. Let's keep him over there. But I think we could go for the engineer. I think I'm gonna go for the engineer. This is fucking risky. I'm gonna go for the engineer until Cedric is out of med bay. So I'm gonna scan there until he's out of med bay. Oh please.
I do not think I could have.
So that's decrypted. So 42 intel extra.
Intriguing.
Thank you very much. And then we're gonna go for. Which is next? Which is next? I should go for maybe the turret breakdown. No, that's UFO attacks. Maybe the mech. I think I'm gonna go for the mech.
These robotic units developed by Advent seem to be wholly autonomous, capable of targeting and engaging selected units without reliance on external verification. Although it falls on me to work through the initial disassembly, I fully intend on involving Shen in this process, as her knowledge of robotics far outweighs my own.
Of course she is, because, yeah, she's the engineer, of course. So that's that. Let's head back to the bridge.
Resources at their disposal.
Sorry, Tag, I'm going to have to cut you off there, because I think Cedric is still. Let's stop it right there. Just want to quickly check if he's actually still in medbay, or I think he is, yeah. Still see him over there. Ooh, this is cutting it really short. Oh shit, I'm gonna have to ignore that. Or do we do the guerrilla operations first? Yeah, I'm gonna do that. So we're gonna go for the guerrilla operations first, but that will have to wait until the next episode. I'm gonna quickly check them out. I wanna block those rapid responses. Retaliation counter is not that bad. It is difficult though. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the new Arctic.
Setting course for sector 1.
That's gonna bite off a few hours as well. But not that much, so we still have 4 days. And we're gonna do, after this mission, we're gonna immediately do the black side, because otherwise we're gonna be in a hell of a lot of trouble. That's pretty good, but I'm gonna remove Jazz, and we're gonna put in Trophy Nut, so Vinny. I'm gonna give him that spot, because we're gonna need a sharpshooter. But with that said, we're gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.